Genetically engineered plants that can detect bombs could replace expensive electronic detectors within a decade. And WASP-43b is a planet 260 light-years away that features winds blowing at the speed of sound in 3,000-degree temperatures, which is hot enough to melt steel. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is Mind Blow. SpaceWorks Enterprises is designing a deep sleep transfer habitat to help send humans to Mars. Funded by NASA, the project aims to utilize therapeutic hypothermia to slow down astronauts' metabolisms, inducing a sleep-like inactive state for a prolonged period of time. Feeding would occur through intravenous nutritional fluids delivered via catheter. RhinoChill is an intranasal cooling system currently used in hospitals to induce therapeutic hypothermia, keeping cardiac arrest victims in stable condition while waiting for treatment. But they currently only do it for up to a week, not the 180 days it takes to get to Mars. So a lot more research is needed to understand its long-term mental and physical effects. RoomAlive transforms your living room into a video game. It uses projector depth camera units to create a unified model of the room and sends that information to a game engine. This proof of concept includes a holodeck, a whack-a-mole game using a gun controller, a robot attack game, and booby-trap virtual darts shooting from the wall that players try to avoid. All of which are just samples of how the system creates augmented entertainment experiences that can be set up in any room. White-footed sportive lemurs don't like seeing their family, but they still care. So to let each other know they're okay, they all pee on the same tree at different times throughout the night. So yeah. A bionic eye has allowed this man to see for the first time in 33 years. I first featured the Argus II retinal prosthesis device on Mind Blow 59, and now Lowry Hester is the 7th person using it in the United States. A sensor implanted in his eye picks up light signals sent from a camera mounted on the glasses, not restoring normal eyesight, but allowing Hester to see flashes of light that help him differentiate his surroundings, like telling the difference between a wall and a door. So far, he says the best moment for him was seeing, reaching out, and touching his wife's face.
Can you really see?
Yes.
This is an animated map of a humpback whale's song. Michael Deal used shapes resembling the notation of Gregorian chants to visualize whales' incredible underwater music in hopes to further spread awareness for saving whales. A Swedish truck driver has been using a mind-controlled prosthetic arm for a year with no complications. The arm attaches to a titanium implant integrated with the bone, and it's controlled with his biological nerves and muscles. And they're currently working on sending that communication back to the brain to provide intuitive sensory feedback, allowing people to also feel with the prosthetic hand. Indonesia's capital is sinking into the sea, and they're hoping to save it with a $40 billion project that will take 30 years. Jakarta is dropping between 2.9 and 6.7 inches per year, mostly due to groundwater extraction leaving large caverns under the city which are collapsing. So the plan is to construct 17 new islands and a massive seawall in Jakarta Bay to protect from flooding, with a waterfront shaped like the mythical Garuda bird, the national symbol of Indonesia. Researchers from the University of Southern Denmark have created a crystal that can absorb and release oxygen. A bucket full of the material, which is a salt made from cobalt, can suck up and store all the oxygen in a room. It can be reused many times without losing its effectiveness, and the hope is to someday use it to drastically lighten oxygen tanks. A scuba diver would only need to carry a few grains of this stuff because the crystal could absorb oxygen from the water. Finally, Susi Sie blends art and science by using analog techniques to explore the mathematical nature of unusual substances. I'm gonna leave you with a ping pong playing robot, and as always, thanks for watching.